Hey guys, what up? Today we are gonna be doing something different. So this is a new series that I'm starting off. It is known as Hip Hop Breakdown. So what I'll be doing is basically breaking down hip hop song. Some of them have a lot of meaning in them and some of them don't mean shit. And they have just really good music. So today I'm gonna be starting off with Eminem. The song is called The Ringer. It's from this album called Kamikaze. Little bit of a backdrop to this album. Before Kamikaze released, Eminem had a new album called Revival. So this was more of his attempt to keep up with what was happening in the world at that time, and he just changed the sound of his music. So some of those songs were really good. River, Chloroseptic, and there was one more song called No Place Like Home with Alicia Keys. They were all good songs, but it did not sit well with all the stans. Stans are basically fans of Eminem. The Ringer is the first song in the album Kamikaze. Kamikaze is named after this whatever happened at Pearl Harbor. So the starting of the song goes off with plane crash. So that's something to watch out for. Let's start with the song.
Yeah. I'm just gonna write down my first thoughts. See where this takes me. Cause I feel like I wanna punch the girl in the fucking face right now.
Yeah. Let me explain just how to make greatness. Straight out the gate, I'm about to break you down. Ain't no mistakes allowed, but make no mistake, I'm about to break the alphabet. I make waves, some rounds, if I press the issue just to get the anger out. Full magazine can text page, pulls out savage, but ain't thinking about a bank account. But bitch, I'm off the chain like Taylor Brown.
Savage, but I ain't thinking about the bank account. That is a direct shot at 21 Savage's bank account song. I don't know why, what he has against 21 Savage, but yeah, he just like went off on everybody in this song. So let's just continue.
Motherfuckers, shut the fuck up when I'm talking, little bitch. I'm sorry, wait, what's your talent? Oh, ticket, my talent. Oh, bitch, I don't know who the fuck y'all are to give us up our bar or even have an opinion. If you mention me, millions of views, attention and news. I mention you, lose for me, win win for you. Billions of views, your 10 cents of blue. Skim through the music to give shit reviews. To keep clicks, the bitch, you just lit the fuse.
So that is basically him going off at YouTubers and anyone who reacts to his songs. So he says, if you mention me, you get millions of views. But if I mention you, you get billions of views. So that's something that you've got to think about. That's what he says.
To get misconstrued, business is used, shitless renewed, or get shit to do, or get pissed cause I just don't get what the fuck half the shit is that you're listening to. Do you have any idea how much I hate this copy? Blow everyone copies, they'll probably know. Get this fucking audio on my audio. So I can see why people like Lil Yachty, but
get this fucking audio out of my audio. Get this fucking audio out of my audio.
But not me though, not even dissing it, this ain't for me. All I am simply is just an MC. Maybe stand just isn't your cup of tea. Maybe a cup full of syrup and lean. Maybe I need to stir up shit, preferably shake the world up if it burns to me. Paul wants me to chill, don't want me to ill. I should eat a pill, probably I will. Hold me, kill the new me, watch him bleed to death. I breathe on a mirror, I don't see my breath. Possibly I'm dead, I must be possessed. Like an evil spell, M-E-V-I-L.
So here, Paul wants me to chill. He's basically talking about his lawyer, Paul Rosenberg. Before this album came out, he was advised greatly by everyone to not do it because it was just him, like, just dissing everybody in the world. And he was asked not to do it. And this album had no marketing whatsoever. It just dropped. One day, there was no Kamikaze, and the other day, the whole wide world just lost it.
Democrats white strip in the tip of my dick with an ice pick, sticking in the vice grip, hang it on a spike fence, bang it with a pipe wrench. While I take my ball second, flick it like a light switch. Like Vice President Mike Pence, back up on my shit in a sidekick as I lay it on a spike strip. These are things that I'd rather do with you on a mic since 9 10. Your mind is about ice and Jesus Christ, man. How many times is someone gonna fuck a mic?
my bitch. You won't ever see M.I.C. But as cold as I get on the M.I.C. I polarize shit so the temps might freeze it.
So here he's going on about all the mumble rappers who just talk about their bitches and just degrading women in the very bad way. And then he goes on to say, you won't ever see M.I.C. I.C. as in like all this drip and all these diamond chains that all these rappers have. You will never see Eminem like that. So he goes like, you won't ever see M.I.C. And then he goes, but as cold as I get on the M.I.C. on the mic.
Then his whole mic split like I passed to one side. Bitch, I got the club on smash like a nightstick. What? I ain't loud enough. Nah, turn the volume up, cause I don't know how I'm gonna get your mouth to shut now when it doesn't matter.
So he's known for like, you know, twisting words in a very creative way. And this is one of those lines where he goes, turn down for what? I ain't loud enough. Nah, turn the volume up. So he's talking about volume, at the same time he's talking about volume.
Matter what caliber I spit at, I'll bet $100,000 you'll turn around and just be like, man, how the fuck Sourpuss gonna get mad just cause his album sucks and now he wants to take it out on us? Well, last week in its fan, got me a copy of the map, it's up to tell me to study, it'll help me get back to my seven, she'll love me. I mailed the bitch back and said if I did that, I'd just be like everyone else in the fucking industry, especially in that theme recovery clone of me. Finger bang, chicken wing, DJ K, nigga Zay, Lil Pump, Lil Zan, Tim and Tate, Lil Wayne, that's the name of everybody in the game, pick a name, I'm fed up with being home.
So here is just like, fuck everyone. He's like Lil Pump, Lil Zan. They all end up imitating Lil Wayne. Lil Wayne is the guy who started everything. He's a freestyle rapper, and Lil Wayne and Eminem go back a long way. And all these guys just started Lil, and they just started mumbling out of nowhere. And he says that, just pick a name and I'll go at them.
And rumor is I'm hungry, I'm sure you heard rumbling. I heard you wanna rumble, like an empty stomach. I heard you mumbling, but it's jumbled and mumble trouble. The error that I'm from, I'm plumbing you. That's what it's coming to. What the fuck you gonna do when you run into it? I'm gonna come with you and I'll take a number two and dump on you if you ain't joining. If you ain't Kendrick, go call the Sean and you're a coming. I'm about to bring it to anyone in this bitch.
So he gives a positive shout out here to Kendrick, Cole and Joyner, saying that they are the people who are actually trying to rap and the others are just fucking around.
You want it? I guess when you walk into BK, you expect the viral. You can order a quarter pound when you go to McDonald's, but if you're looking to get a border house, you better go get revival. But y'all are acting like I tried to serve you up a slider. Maybe the rubble should have been auto-tuned and you would have bought it. But saying I no longer got it because you missed the line and never caught it. Because it went over your head because you're too stupid to get it. Because you're mentally retarded, but pretend to be the smartest with your expertise and knowledge. But you'll never be an artist and I'm harder on myself than you could ever be. Regardless, but I'll never be as flawless. All I ever be is honest, even when I'm gonna say I brought it. Even when I hit my 40s like a fucking alcoholic with a bottle full of malt liquor. But I couldn't bottle this shit any longer. The fact that I know that I'm gonna hit my bottom. If I don't pull myself from the jaws of defeat and rise to my feet, I don't see why y'all even started with me. I get in peace, my enemies die. I don't cease fire till at least all of the seats. I'm east side, never.
So he goes like, I get in beefs, my enemies die, and he says he doesn't cease fire until everyone is deceased. That's the kind of wordplay you'll never find in any rapper's song. And like, I'm sorry to say this to anyone out there, and Eminem is the best lyricist on earth, period. So he just goes on flexing about how he doesn't blink and he doesn't even doze off and he doesn't even blink when he sneezes. And that is the biggest flex you can ever do on someone, honestly.
Oh man, the BET cypher was weak, it was garbage, the thing ain't even orange, oh my god, that's a reach. Shout out to all my colorblind people, each and every one of y'all. If you call a fire engine green, aquamarine, or you think water is pink, dog has a dang, looks like an olive to me. Look, there's an apple, no it's not, it's a peach. Burger King, Gucci Gang, Nicky Dang, Charlemagne. Gonna hate anyway, doesn't matter what I say. Give me donkey on the day, gonna wait for 2018 to get underway, but I'm gonna say
So he has a huge beef with Charlemagne the God. He's a talk show host and he's known for giving Donkey of the Day award to all the rappers that he thinks suck. So when Revival came out, he just ended up giving Donkey of the Day to Eminem and he did not like it. And he took it personally and in Kamikaze, he just destroyed him.
everything that I wanna say. Welcome to the slaughterhouse, bitch. Yeah. Invite him in like I want a day. I'm not done. Cause I feel like the beast of burden. That line in the sand, was it even worth it? Cause the way I see people turn is making it seem worthless. You're starting to defeat the purpose. I'm watching my fan base shoot the thirds. And I was just trying to do the right thing. But word is the court of public opinion reached the verdict. But still yet to be determined. Cause I'm determined to be me. Critique the worship. But if I could go back, I'd at least reword it. And say I empathize with the people. This evil serpent sold the dreams of the beast deserted. Working these verses, I'm making him a wee bit nervous, and he's disturbed to answer me with words, cause he knows that he will lyrically get murdered.
So, and this is also a small dig at Portis. He just goes off during the BT cipher in 2017. Every single rapper who participated in the cipher just went against Donald Trump. And this guy was the worst. He did the worst damage, and he explains it.
Well, I know at least he's heard it, cause Agent Orange just sent the Secret Service to meet in person to see if I really think of hurting him or ask if I'm linked to terrorists. I said only when it comes to ink and lyricism.
Yeah, that's what he did. So when he went off on the Portis, so the Secret Service was sent to Eminem's studio to check if he had any bad intention towards the president, and that is just messed up.
But my beef is more media journalists. I said my beef is more media journalists. Can get a mouthful of flesh. And yes, I mean eating a penis. Cause they've been panning my album to death. So I've been giving the media fingers. Don't wanna turn this to a counseling sesh. But they've been putting me through the ringer. So I ain't ironing shit out with the press. And I just took the feet to the cleaners.
Alright guys, that was Eminem, The Ringer. It's the first song in the Kamikaze album. I just really wanted to react to this song because it is one of the most well-written songs, except all the penis jokes and the way he has crafted his words in this album. It's not just this song, there's a song called Lucky You, Not Like Greatest. All of these songs, he just takes a dig at every single mumble rapper, and he says that these are the people who are ruining hip-hop. And since it's the new world sound right now, everyone just wants to listen to good music, and nobody cares about the message behind the entire song. So this is one of the rapper who just wants people to hear what he's saying. And along with him, it's again, even I agree with him, it's Kendrick, J. Cole, and Joyner Lucas. And there are many more who are going the right way with hip hop, and even Hobson, Logic. I will try and react to some of their songs, explain how they what they mean, and why it was made the way it is. And until next time, thank you guys so much for watching. And if you like my content, please let me know, please DM me so that I can correct whatever mistake I'm doing, and also follow me and subscribe.